Handedness is a universal human trait. Some people prefer the left hand, some the right, and some are ambidextrous and can use both. But what about your dog? Can it be left pawed? Hey, left-handed mice users, I'm Jules here for DNews. Human handedness is influenced by a huge number of genes and environmental factors. That being said, a consistent 10% of the human population is left-hand dominant. So there's definitely a big genetic component. A study in PLOS Genetics identified a gene, PCSK6, which helps determine how the body organizes itself in early development and correlated it with hand dominance. But if handedness is genetic, shouldn't we see it throughout the rest of the natural world too? Well, it is seen in some animals. For example, great apes have handedness. It's been detailed in studies published in Behavioral Brain Research and Animal Cognition. Scientists have theorized one of the influencing factors of hand dominance is rooted in the language processing part of the brain. But it could also have been passed down by our ancestors thanks to the use of our tools. The studies on great apes found that they use different hands for different activities. They preferred their right hand for inanimate targets, like sticks or toys. But for grooming, they didn't report any dominance at all. Researchers believe this may be due to which hemisphere of the brain is being used. Grooming is emotional and social, while grabbing sticks is for purely functional purposes. 70% of chimps are right-handed for functional tasks, like manipulating a tool, or, hilariously, which hand they choose when they throw feces at researchers. MRI scans, again, showed it was probably due to brain hemispheres. Evolutionarily, scientists believe this preference for one hand may have appeared even before chimps and humans split from their common ancestor, as the scans showed similar structures in our own brains. Some enterprising researchers found similar brain structures towards handedness exists in cats, but with a twist. They're sex-specific. When cats went to play with toys or remove food from jars, they found that females preferred to use their right paw, while males went left. Cat brains have this weird specialization too. Dogs, on the other paw, don't seem to have this brain specialization. A 2006 study in behavioral processes found no population-level preference for a dominant hand, but that it might just be split 50-50. Scientists haven't just studied our fur babies, though. Kangaroos were discovered to be hand-specific. Weirdly, most of them are lefties. And frogs were found to prefer the right foot for some tasks. Fish prefer one eye to the other when spotting predators, and even some birds, like chickens and pigeons, have brain-level hemisphere specializations for some visual tasks. But overall, quadruped animals aren't often studied for handedness. One, because they don't really have hands, and two, because they're usually walking on all of their limbs. That's obviously a weird thing to think about. But handedness is kind of weird anyway. Even though we've identified some genes involved, geneticists don't agree on the exact process of how it happens. So we don't really know where it comes from. It just is. And overall, as usual, more research is needed. We can't do episodes like this without our sponsors. If you listen to music and podcasts and are looking for a new Bluetooth speaker, check out Monster's reimagined boombox, the Monster Blaster. It's available for monthly payments starting at $25. The Monster Blaster has the power to bring music to life indoors and out. Check it out at themonsterblaster.com/dnews. To blow your mind even further, animals aren't the only thing scientists have found to have left or right handedness. Molecules and chemicals can be handed too. Find out why right here. And what about your pet? Do they have a preferred claw or paw or flipper? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to DNews for more episodes every day.